Next, we're going to talk about the long-run equilibrium of monopolistic competition. Here is a bottom line. Due to low entry barrier, every firm is going to make a zero economic profit in the long run. Due to low entry barrier, if there is economic profit for existing firms, that will attract entry. And as there are more firms entering the market, that will shift your supply curve to the right, bringing down the price, which means the existing firms will be making a zero economic profit again because of the lower price. Now, if existing firms are suffering economic loss, that would trigger exit, meaning some firms will leave the industry and the supply curve will shift to the left, bringing the price back up. So those firms that stay in the industry previously were suffering a loss, but now given the higher price because of the exit, these firms that remain will start to make a zero economic profit again. So due to low entry barrier, we can see that in the long run, every firm in monopolistic competition will be making a zero economic profit. Here is a long run equilibrium for our firm in monopolistic competition. Each firm will set marginal revenue equal to marginal cost to find the quantity Q star. And given Q star, we go back to the demand curve to see what is the price we should charge. So given quantity Q star, we will charge price P star. Notice that because of zero economic profit, your price P star is exactly equal to your average total cost. And the point is here. The long run equilibrium of monopolistic competition is inefficient. And as a result, we have a deadweight loss. The deadweight loss is at the red shaded area. And I'm going to explain why we have this deadweight loss. Here are the reasons why we have a deadweight loss. First of all, the optimal quantity for monopolistic competition does not occur at the lowest point of average total cost. You can see we're producing quantity Q star. And at quantity Q star, you see that our average total cost is still going down. And therefore, we're not producing at the lowest point of ATC. As a result, we do not have productive efficiency. Second of all, because price is greater than marginal cost, there is no allocative efficiency. We know that allocative efficiency is this. Any consumer whose willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost should get the product. Think about this. If it only takes extra $5 to produce a product and I'm willing to pay $10, then I should get the product. But in monopolistic competition, because price is higher than marginal cost, so we could have a consumer whose willingness to pay is in between the price and marginal cost, then this consumer is not going to get the product. For example, let's assume that we have a consumer whose willingness to pay is at the green spot. Now, the consumer's willingness to pay is higher than the marginal cost. Why? Because marginal cost is below the green spot. But this consumer's willingness to pay, the green spot, is lower than the price P star. So this consumer is not going to get the product. And in fact, not just that consumer, but all consumers whose willingness to pay is between this point, P star, and this point, marginal cost. All these consumers, they have a willingness to pay that's lower than the price P star, but greater than the marginal cost. And it's just too bad these consumers will not get the product. And you can see the welfare loss is exactly this red triangle. Now you might be asking, since monopolistic competition is inefficient, why don't we do anything about it? Here's the reason. The market is very competitive because we have many firms in the market. And second, the variety that consumers enjoy can justify the small inefficiency. Remember, only perfect competition is efficient. And one feature of perfect competition is homogeneous products. Can you imagine if industries of apparel and restaurants were perfectly competitive? In that case, for apparel, we will all be wearing the same outfit, like white t-shirt and jeans. Everyone wears the same clothes. And for restaurants, it could be like everyone eats hamburgers and fries. Then that's very boring, right? So we say that we still like variety, and the little inefficiency can be justified by the variety we enjoy. And that's the reason why we don't do anything about inefficiency in monopolistic competition.